You have seen my video on anterior approach to the cervical spine. You have also seen the technique of interbody fusion. You have also seen the technique of interbody fusion using titanium cages many times. You feel the need to stabilize the spine after having done the interbody fusion with an additional plate which you keep over the vertebral body and fix it with the screws. That is what I am with the technique of it. I am going to show to you on a model.
This is the tray showing various sizes of the plates and the screws. This is one such plate. It is called Z plate because it has the shape of a Z. To hold a plate, this is the holder. It has outer and the inner sheath. At the end, it has got a slot. The central two grooves are meant for holding the plate. You fix the groove of the holder into it and then forcefully fix the outer sheath inside so that the plate is held in position. These are the holes, two at the top and two at the bottom. They are angled outwards by 15 degrees. They are not straight. The reason being, if we put the hook straight, it may turn loose. By putting it at an angle, the perch of the plate on the cervical spine is much stronger. This is the guide. Once it fits in correct position, it is also at an angle of 15 degrees. If it is not, then it does not fix, it just comes out. The guide is fixed in position and this is the drill. It will go through the guide and drill into the bone at a depth of 13 millimeters. Because the length of the screw is 13 millimeters. The drill is being taken out. Now the hole is made into the next slot. You see the holes, they are angled at a direction of 15 degrees. Now the holes will be made at the lower end. Once again, this is the guide, this is the drill, and it will drill the hole. Once it is complete, then you put the next hole. This is the tap. You really don't require the guide once the direction has been established. And you tap the hole in the direction that has been already made. One and the second. These are the screws. This is the holder, like iron ore holder for the screw, which holds the screw tightly. And what you have to do is to fix it in position. The second screw, the third, and the fourth.
We have put at an angle of 15 degrees. All the same, these screws are not self-locking, and therefore there is a remote possibility that these screws can become loose, and therefore we have to lock the screws. Since the screws themselves are not self-locking, we got a system by which you can lock the screws now.
These are the screws. This is the top portion and this is the bottom portion. You need two screws to lock this plate in position. This is the holder for the screw. Once again, it has a notch at the tip. This notch goes into the groove on the screw. You push in the outer sheath and the screw is picked up. It is fixed in position, and once it is fixed, you just take one rotation with the holder. Then take out the holder. You can see the screw in position, and it is tightened in position with the help of a screwdriver. When the screw is tightened, it makes a noise and you are sure that it is held in position. Once one screw is fixed, you now fix the second screw at the lower end. And this is the